Hello there. I use drone DJI Mavic Air. I really love it, but after half a year of using it, I have doubts about its ActiveTrack mode. Is it really good? And today I have come to this park to make tests and decide for myself, should I ever use this mode? And if I should, in which cases? We are going to make comparison of the active track mode versus manual drone control. Each way has its pros and cons and is good for a certain purpose. First issue with the active track mode is that it often loses a target. In this case, the reason of losing is obvious. It's because the object temporarily hid under the tree. And in this case, reason is not so clear. I suppose it's because the object moved from bright spot into shade and became hard to distinguish. This leads to the conclusion that for an active track mode, you should choose an object which color seriously differs from the ground. So if you are filming a car on a gray road, you should pick a car of a bright color. In this case, reason of target losing is unclear. Maybe it's because of light and shade, maybe it's because the car is moving too fast. The second issue with the active track mode that it doesn't predict the object's trajectory. It just responds to the object's moving. That's why the drone always falls behind the target. In this case, drone starts looking down on the car at almost 90 degrees angle. During the shot, the car gradually moves forward, and eventually the drone gets a view on the car from behind. This is the start position, and this is the final frame. So if you want to get a shot with the camera looking down at constant angle, you should use a manual control. In a manual mode, you have a freedom to compose the shot. Following the rules of frame composition, you should leave more space in front of a moving object and less space behind it. In an active track mode, you have no options. The object is locked in the middle of the frame. When camera keeps the object in the middle of the frame, you may lose surrounding scenery and space in front of the object. Here is an example. We're in an active track mode. Our attention is locked on the car, and we miss a great view in front of the car. And it can be easily captured in a manual mode. Here is another example. In an active track mode, we watch the bicyclist and we see some space around him. And in manual mode, we see the park, the sky and clouds, and it makes the shot more impressive. Which pros does the active track mode have? Firstly, it requires less time to prepare and make a shot. The drone follows the object with the same speed as the object. While in a manual mode, you have to synchronize the speed of your drone with the object. You might require several takes to achieve it. My usual tip for the manual shooting. Use a simple camera trajectory, a straight line. Don't do turns and camera adjustments during the shot. Manual camera turning is not going to be smooth and will lead to a non-professional look of your video. And the active track mode moves the camera really smooth. That's why if you want your camera to make turns, you should use the active track mode. In the manual mode, move your drone along the straight line and let your object swing from left to right in the frame. As the conclusion, personally, I'm going to stick to the manual mode, and I'm going to use the active track mode only if I'm limited in time or I really want my drone to make turns. That's all I've got for today. If you can share your experience with the active track mode or you disagree with me at some point, I'd really appreciate if you leave a comment about it. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video. Goodbye.